Some long-awaited showers drenched Tucson this week. The monsoon got off to a mild start with rain totals well below what the National Weather Service considers normal for July. We explored how forecasters predict the season with Michael Crimmins, an expert in climatology at the University of Arizona.
The official monsoon season is June 15th through September 30th. That's set by the National Weather Service. But that's just a season and when we can expect conditions to kind of move towards the monsoon. But really, the monsoon doesn't typically set in until around July 4th. This year, we are definitely running a week or two late. It has been a little bit later than usual. We're not in record territory. This is not, you know, record late. It's not even record dry. It's definitely in the bottom third of years when we look back in the historical books.
Okay, hard question. What do we attribute all this to?
Oh, that is a hard question. I'm not sure. We're going to need to kind of study this one and look backwards. The weather pattern from the winter held on right through May. And if you remember, May was beautifully cool. It was actually wet. It rained in late May. It felt like April. We did March three times, basically last spring. That weather pattern held on into June and kind of it kept the monsoon from progressing north. Even Mexico was struggling to have the monsoon progression push north. So everything just got delayed. And so now we're finally starting to see those signs of the movement. We're now really waiting for that to reach far enough north to start to quell some of the fires like the museum fire in Flagstaff.
Many of us excited about this week's monsoon. Does that mean it comes later? We'll see more excitement in the coming weeks then.
So it's interesting. July, what happens in July doesn't portend to what happens in August. If you go back in the historical books, they're not necessarily correlated. We can have every combination of a dry July, a wet August, a dry July, and even a dry August. So we don't really know. Climatologically, though, August is the wettest month of the monsoon, and the first week of August is actually the highest chance climatologically of precipitation. So we're right in that sweet spot in the next couple of weeks to really expect the monsoon activity to ramp up and then start to tail off as we head into fall.
Here in the Southwest, maybe just Arizona, how much of our yearly precipitation is attributed to the monsoon?
Just a little over half here in Tucson. If you go to the Northwest, it actually falls off precipitously, not to use that word, kind of punny. Phoenix sees more of their precipitation from the wintertime, maybe a little bit more even 50-50. You go further north, it's more winter. And if you go to the Southeast, Southeast Arizona sees about 60% of its annual total precip occurring during the monsoon season.
Now, for those of us who are not scientists, some of us think that means we're going to have a wetter winter. Does this, the monsoon really tell us anything about what's to come?
No, it doesn't. These seasons are really disconnected from each other. And so what we're now looking forward to is looking at El Nino. That's basically our only tool to kind of anticipate what might happen in the winter with precipitation. We had a weak El Nino this past winter. It is now tailed off to it's about neutral. There's some indication that it might return to weak El Nino conditions next winter. So it kind of leaves us in this maybe average to slightly above average, hopefully taking that dry winter off the table.
Okay, so we shouldn't be discouraged that it's been a little bit slower this
year. Don't be discouraged. I know. I think that the last 2 years set some high expectations. Last year, by this time in the season, we had already had 3.5 inches. So I think that sort of, you know, recency bias of thinking about last summer, expecting last summer to happen again, we shouldn't expect that. We should expect to see something a little bit more closer to climatology. This one's a little bit later, and then looking forward to August as being a bit wetter.